Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieku, and today I'm gonna be showing you how I modeled these bags. It's actually one bag. I just cloned it and just turned it around. So I modeled this bag, and as you can see, this is a nice close-up of the bag. It's fairly detailed, and this is another close-up of the handle, etc., etc. So I'm gonna show you how I did this. The method that I used for this is a manual retopology. Manual retopology is a bit different from automatic retopology. With automatic, you just press a button and then a random mesh appears, where with manual retopology, you are carefully placing pretty much each polygon, and you're generally like creating, you know, a specially crafted object just for your needs. So I started with this whole thing pretty much scanning this bag. Like, this bag that I scanned, I just filled it with some props, I hung it somewhere, and I did a 3D scan of it in reality capture. I'm gonna also do reality capture video on how I generally scan my objects for, you know, 3D retopology. But once my scan was done, I pretty much imported it into my Max, and I got this. So this is the bag that I filled with some goodies, but as you can see here, the whole thing is almost 40 million polygons big. And when I zoom in, you can see like this is like a web of edges, like millions of edges. So I generally did the retopology on this, and the finished product pretty much looks like this. So this is that same bag, just retopologized, and like this is the polygon difference. It looks much tidier than this. Okay, so let me generally explain the whole process. I was using two things, extend and conform. So by extend and conform, I mean this extend here, like it's in the ribbon under the freeform. So extend, and I used all these conform tools. It's fairly simple to use. Like, you do have some adjustment because you kind of have to get used to the whole, you know, shortcut keyboard combination, but you generally learn that pretty quickly. So how do you go about generally starting with topology? One of the main things that you have to do first is go to the default shading here and click display selected, and just click display selected with edged faces. What does that mean? That means that any object that you select, you will see a wireframe of that object. For retopology, that's actually turbo important, because if you want to see a wireframe of this, and just imagine that you're, you know, working on this wireframe while this monstrosity is visible in the back, it's kind of hard to see. Default shading, display selected with edge faces, keep that on. Now, convert this little plane to editable poly, and now the extend and conform options will be available to you. Next, where you see where it says grid, click on the little drop down menu and click on draw on surface. Now click the pick button here, and this is where you select your scan. So as you can see, it says bag high quality. Now what does this do? Extend and conform are options that are gonna draw objects on different surfaces. So I need to draw a new bag on the scan. So this is where you pick it, and now Max knows that, you know, this is the surface that you need to pretty much apply your stuff on. But let me quickly show you how this is generally done. So let me just enable the extend, and I'm just gonna quickly start generating polygons, and you're gonna get the idea on what this thing does. So I'm gonna move this one here, this one there, this one here, and this one there, let's say like this. And now look at this. Let me just make them a little bit more pretty. Okay, so now just drag polygon here, drag here, drag here. Move these, for example, here, here, and then, you know, move this one there, then extrude this one out, bridge these two. And as you can see, all the polygons are just conforming pretty much on the object, and that's pretty much how you create the entire thing. Now, let me explain what I did. So extend is purely based on shortcuts. Shortcuts are everything for extend. So let me just undo this. So if you just hover on the extend, you're gonna see all the shortcuts that you need, but let me just cover the basics. If you hold shift and just move the polygon down, just holding shift and just clicking, it's gonna start creating polygons. If you're holding control shift and you move it to the left, for example, it's gonna start creating like entire row of polygons. As you can see, one polygon pretty much escaped here, or like, you know, the vertex was not placed correctly. So what you can do now, if you press control Alt and Shift, you're pretty much just gonna move like a single vertex. So you can just, you know, move single vertices and just, you know, make them look whatever you like. Now I'm gonna, you know, move this here and let's say move this here. If you just solo click here, you can just, you know, drag out polygons like this and you're just laying out polygons. It's that simple. Now, if I do, for example, this, and I'm gonna extend this one and this one, if I hold Control Alt, this will pretty much do the bridge feature. So Control Alt, and you just swipe across two edges and they're gonna be merged. One cool thing is, if you go to isolation mode where you just isolate this whole thing, you can still draw with the extend because it will take in consideration that the 3D scan is still here. So now you can pretty much, you know, like continue drawing blindly. But if you want, in general, you know, you can do your modifications here. Another cool thing is you can just easily delete polygons. You just control click and you're just deleting stuff. And that's pretty much how extend works. So it's a very, very simple, you know, process. And like once you get your base of polygons or whatever, you know, in general, you will just be like extending stuff, etc. Now, one thing that's also very important. You got this little offset here. So what does the offset do? Offset pretty much says when you create a point on this 3D scan, how much it will be spaced out from the surface. I usually keep like, I mean, it really depends from the scenario, but I always keep my offset on like 1 or 2 millimeters away from the surface. It's, it, you know, like if it's a large surface. So for this, you just have to experiment with the number. I'm just going to put offset 0.2. And now if I create, let's say a new polygon here, you can see where the points here, like you, I don't know if you can feel like, but they're a little bit spaced away from the surface where points on the other side here, they're actually pressing against the surface. If I make this actually a little bit more extreme, let's say I'm just going to put number 2 instead of 0.2. Now this is what it does. See this? Like this is how much the polygon is spaced out. Like if I move it up, you can see it's like really, really spaced out from the object. Now, why would you use offset in the first place? Well, do you see these polygons? You don't. And that's because they're so much pressed in that, you know, any sort of bumpy deformations are actually going to hide the polygons. And because of that, I always like to see majority of my model that I'm modeling. I don't want it to be concealed that much. Now, let's go to conform. And I'm going to actually, you know, make a little bit of a mess here. So I'm just going to select a couple of these polygons and I'm just going to move them out like this, you know, because I don't know, you have a scenario like that, or move it up like here. So conform, when you click it, you get this little window and you get like a brush here. I got my object here, which is, you know, fairly spaced out. So what you can do with conform brush, you can pretty much just press it in like this. You see, and the whole object is actually being pressed in. And it's also following this 0.2 offset that I have. Now, one thing that you want to keep in mind is conform value, like the intensity of the conform. By default, it's, I think, set to 1 or like 0.1 or something like that. I always increase it to a large number, like 30 or 50. But let me just show you what like what it does when it's like when it's on a lower value. You see like this surface, I'm going to start conforming it. You see how it's like slowly conforming? It doesn't go very fast. Well, if you just bump up the conform strength to, let's say, 50, it's going to pretty much press everything, you know, instantly onto the surface. Now, speaking of conform, conform has a lot of cool features. You have different conform brushes here. One of my favorite for Retopology is the Relax. So Relax Conform Brush. Now look what this one does. So I just activated my Relax Conform Brush. And as you can see, my topology currently doesn't look that sexy. Yeah, I could go into, for example, extend mode here. And, you know, by holding Control Alt Shift, I can just, you know, move polygons around to try and make them more, you know, even, etc. But if you use the Relax Conform Brush, this brush will relax the surface, plus it will conform it. So look at this. If I just undo here to what, you know, to where I was, and now look, when I'm just conforming with the relax, it's actually repositioning my polygons, and I can make those polygons to actually look much nicer on the whole entire thing. And I don't need to worry about, you know, like if
if some, you know, edge flow was a little bit wavy, you can always use the Relax Conform brush and you can just make everything, you know, nice and smooth. This is pretty much how I got, you know, the whole topology on this whole thing to look so nice and even. And that's pretty much it. This is how I modeled this entire bag. So let me just open like my first version when I started the whole retopology process of the bag. This is the density that I started with, right? So I pretty much did this super low poly version of it. And then the next thing that I did, I pretty much subdivided the whole thing. Then from this point, I literally just turned conform again. And now I just started, you know, conforming with these denser polygons on my, you know, on my scan. And now, you know, when I was done with that, I would pretty much, you know, just add another layer of subdivision, you know, like this. And then I would use the conform brush again and pretty much, you know, like conform in all the little small details. On this model, you can actually even use a conform modifier. So just click on the modifier list and select conform. Before you pick any objects, I advise that you first set up what you want to do. So I'm just going to click on volume, shrink wrap, and direction. It's going to be, I don't know, closest point. And now I'm just going to go pick object and I'm going to pick my scan. And now in a couple of seconds, you pretty much see this. Like all the polygons have conformed to my scan. And you can even, you know, set the offset number, you know, like 0.2 if you want to match your conforms offset, and you're going to get this. But the point is, you know, now that, you know, like I've done this, if I just smash Turbo Smooth on it, look, I pretty much got the bag that I showed you. But in general, this is what I use pretty much to model everything. Like if I can get my hand on like a 360 video footage where I can create a 3D scan, I'm always going to do retopology. Of course, apart from hard surface, if I have a table, I'm not going to do that. But for example, any type of sofas or anything, I will always use, you know, a scan and just do the retopology on it. Now, if you come this far in the video, if you like this bag that I did, I'm actually giving it away for free. So down in the description, you're going to find a link where you can just freely download this bag. And yeah, by the way, UV scale on the whole thing is 50 times 50 centimeters, if anyone cares. But yeah, in general, I really enjoy doing retopology, mostly because you don't have to worry about the size of things. You don't have to eyeball something, look at the images, try to get the size right, because the size or everything is already defined in the scan. Your only job here is to make a pretty topology, nothing else. You don't worry about if something is puffy enough, you know, not puffy enough, you know, thin, etc. You know, you get all the proportions there. You're pretty much just drawing the thing on top of an existing object. I don't know. I find it very relaxing. I love doing retopology. But speaking of 3D scanning, Evermotion started to scan things. Look, they have 3D scanned assets. And the starting price is like from €2. And all these assets are really, really high quality. Look at this. Like, look at this tire thing. Look at it. It's crisp. It's so damn crisp. So yeah, check out Evermotion website for their new 3D scanned assets. They really, really look dope. And see you in the next video. Bye.